Be prepared to go hard, go hard for a long time. Oh, the Northern Arts and Cultural Center, pardon me, the Northern Scene is a two-week festival that's going to be put on by the National Arts Center in Ottawa. And it's only covering the three territories. So we'll have performing artists, musicians, we'll have culinary artists, anything and everything that is creative will be looked at, including textiles and jewelry and whatnot. They do have some information on the Northern or the National Arts Center website as well. But if you would like more information on that, you can also contact Boris Adamenenko at the NWT Arts Council. He'll get back to you in August. Any other comments, questions, concerns? Jessica? No? Okay. She answered it. Good. Great. Okay. We'll move on to the Vice President's report.
How do you want to work the microphone here?
Yeah, cozy up.
Thank you. Pardon me. good evening. Thank you for this opportunity, Madam President.
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay, Vice President Report 2012. 2011, sorry.
Speaking.
Okay, is that better? Can we hear me now? Thank you. I'm not usually on this side of the microphone. 2011-12 was a great year for music NWT. One of the many really important components was having Greg Nutt here, and that was a huge part of the evolution of music NWT over the number of years, over the last couple of years. Over the last couple of years, he's provided and demonstrated good ongoing mentoring and stewardship skills, and I thank him for that. It's been a real pleasure working and learning from him. We saw also the departure of James Baraski, a man that tried his best for music NWT. Early in this last year, Brenda Lowing joined the Music NWT board, and that's also been a great contribution to our growth and metamorphic change. Then along with that, Ted McLeod joined us and became the Secretary Treasurer and demonstrated brilliant skills with many instruments, particularly the Excel spreadsheet, organizing all the many components of an organization. Leanna Goose and more recently Kim Doyle have been added to our to our strength and the breadth of our organization, along with many other regular contributors, particularly Lila Gildes, who has been with the organization since its founding. Paulette O'Neill, our bookkeeper, who has really helped us get our finances all nicely put in a spot where Ted McLeod was able to pick them up and run with them. I also wanted to thank Natasha Deshane, who is recently, for the last while, has really been helping when she's available and pulling in very constructive ways and joining us when she's wherever by Skype if she can't be there in person. In all, the past has been a year of stabilization. Our board, our finance books, our goals, our objectives, and our mission statements have all been solidified. We have garnered further confidence with the government at all levels. We're connected with national and national organizations, along with reinforcing our relationships with our NWT partners. One of the highlights that happened in the last year was that one of our members came up with the idea of the idea originally was a hall of fame for where we could commemorate and celebrate our celebrities. And that quickly led by serendipity to Scott Lau, who joined us for striking a subcommittee looking into some sort of Hall of Fame. That conversation quickly advanced from the Holy Hall of Fame to the ARC project, which was a subcommittee of Music NWT originally. It rapidly emerged and became its own entity, but it demonstrated the hunger for rehearsal and performance spaces. Another component which is close to my heart, and that was, is that Music NWT has been giving away glasses with our logos on them to people all over the place, and they go home, they continually remind people of us and our organization. Ted McLeod was involved and highlighted and delivered to us a strategic planning program, which involves a very broad and wide spreadsheet, which incorporates everything we do between now and the next 5 years, and it can be moved around and prioritized. And it's an awesome, powerful tool for managing not-for-profit societies. How am I doing for time? Okay, one more page. On a personal note, I want to thank the people who I've been helping pull Music NWT into existence, particularly my associates on the board of directors. It's been a long—it's long been a dream of many of us to successfully participate in a strong and vibrant music community here in the Northwest, in the North. As Music NWT continues to mature, I feel we are arriving at this goal. It's been an honor to serve as Vice President of Music NWT, and I want to say thank you all for this opportunity. It's been great to work with such mindful, respectful people. Ms. President, you rock. Finally and lastly, we'll be having an election at the end of during the course of this evening, and that I encourage you all to look around and think about who we want to represent us and move us forward, and who wants to work with moving us forward. I myself have been with Music NWT since its origin and had hiatuses now and then from the organization. But I, even if I were offered a position of vice president again, I would decline the offer. And I strongly encourage you all to look around the room here and think about our future 5 years and who we'd like to see becoming active members of the board. That's the end of my spiel. Brenda, I'm sure it was more than 2 minutes, but thank you for that liberty. Any questions? You're all awake. Thank you.
Thank you, Matthew. Haven't said hardly any two words all year. Now, give you your little moment in the spotlight. All right, on to the business plan 2012. In October 2011, Music NWT was told by both ITI and ECE that until Music NWT had a business plan in place, we would not receive any more funding. Further, any future funding requests had to be clearly earmarked for a specific goal or objective with this business plan in mind. After researching all the information on hand, a draft 5-year business plan was put together by the directors for review. A final 5-year business plan was agreed to and a motion was passed, and the board of directors in December accepted it. Music NWT now has a roadmap in which to follow and has been very well received by our funding agencies. Do you want to hold up the document for me, please, Ted, so everyone can have a look at it? If you haven't received a copy, there are some on the front table. If you would like to receive it electronically, email musicnwt@gmail.com. In the course of our research, it was noted that while Music NWT has clear mandates and objectives, it did not yet have a mission statement. The mission statement that is in our business plan came out of one of the core mandates. Most of the goals and objectives for 2011 have been completed, and any goals and objectives that were not achieved in 2011 have been moved forward to 2012. Any questions, comments, concerns on the business plan? No? Thank you. Moving on to the treasurer's report.
With 2 minutes, I'm going to keep this very brief. On the profit and loss sheet, that's where I'm going to start. The total revenues for January 1, 2011 to December 31st, 2011 is $9,150. With grants, was $26,564. Membership fees revenue was $2,990 for a total income of $38,704. The expenses over the same time period was $41,605.28. So the net income in brackets loss for the year, we spent more than we brought in, which is so we had in the hold, went down $2,901.28. If you go to the balance sheet next, the total money we ended up the year with was $1,360.60. And when you go through everything at the bottom, our total assets is $6,501.40. And we're still waiting for a GST rebate check for $157.69. So total equity we have is $6,659.09. So total liabilities and equity is at $6,501.40. And if you ask me any detailed questions, I'll take your name and your number, and I'll get back to my accountant, and I'll give you all the answers you want. But do feel free to give me a question. Okay.
So if there's no comments or questions, can I get a motion to accept the treasurer's report? Made by Darren, seconded by? Thank you. Jonathan, yeah. Fantastic. Sorry? Oh, yes, yeah, sorry. All those in favor? Any opposed? Carried. Thank you. Now it's back to Ted for the grant committee report.
Grant writing this year was actually quite fun. I haven't done it for a number of years, so I went. We're starting to write grants in a hurry when I found out we had to. We started off the year really with a grant that was put in by James Borowski, so I give credit where credit's due. We got $7,200 from Heritage Canada, Canadian Heritage, sorry, for Cabin Fever 2012. Music NWT has requested over the last year and received funding for the following grants. From ITI, we received a support to send two members to the Western Canada Music Awards in Whitehorse. The cost is what we got. What we got is $4,183.47. We also received support to send two members to the Canadian Music Week in Toronto. We received $4,604 support. Support to pay the Western Canada Music Association membership dues of $15,000. We got that from IT as well. Cabin Fever 2012, we also received $1,750 to cover some advertising costs. From MACA, we applied for and received $4,000 for a strategic planning and governance workshop. From the NWT Arts Council, we've got $15,000. We've just been approved. It's not in our bank account yet. I have a letter from Minister Lafferty. It's $10,000 was a budget for the Folk on the Rocks workshop tent, and $5,000 for a youth workshop in both Yellowknife and Hay River. And when you look at the business plan, you'll see there's a big focus on expanding Music NWT to Hay River this year. And you'll see it when you look at the work plan, a number of entities are working their way from Yellowknife through to Hay River to develop the rest of the Northwest Territories. From the Northern Arts Mentorship, we received, it's in our bank, $7,000. It's the trainer workshops. This is something we're planning likely, and this is a new board will be actually having the idea when they want. We've been thinking it will be with the NAC event in January. With that, there's also the trainers will then go out and do workshops. We're focusing on youth with that one, with the workshop training outside of Yellowknife. Cabin Fever 2013 in Hay River. We have received $5,000, and that's to cover the workshop and artist costs, and we already have a letter of support from the town of Hay River. The city of Yellowknife, we received for advertising costs $1,000 for Cabin Fever 2012. We have submitted a grant application to Heritage Canada for Cabin Fever 2013 in Yellowknife. We've requested $19,300, and traditionally we get about 50% of that, so I'm anticipating about $9,650 for Yellowknife. And we have a letter of support from the city of Yellowknife. We received a letter from Heritage Canada saying that we were unsuccessful in our grant application for Cabin Fever and Hay River because the rules were quite simple. You need to have run a successful event for 2 days in this community prior to applying for it. I put it in there because I felt that we argued, we've done things in Hay River in the past, but they said, better luck next time. Run it one year with 2 day event and you can do it. So, and they recognize that Music NWT is a territorial organization and they will support both when, after we get them both going. We submitted a grant application to Yale Nev Community Foundation for $15,000. We're still waiting a response for that. We're preparing a grant application to Northern Arts Mentorship for operational funding because we do not have operational funding, and that's why we are trying to start the sustainability fund to start work towards that. And we have submitted final reports for all grants over the last year. For those of you who've ever had to do that, they're all in, and we are pleased, and so are they. That's all. Any questions or thoughts? Thank you.
Thank you, Ted. All right. At the end, any articles that don't require financial approval, we'll just do it en masse at the end, an approval of reports. All right, you might need to take a little drink of water there because you're up against, again, with the membership committee report.
This is even shorter. As of June 30th, we have 74 paid members and 58 voting members. And the distinction there is that we still have a small band fee. So any small band will get one vote. And so that's explains the differences, and some of the, I could tell you the bands, but it doesn't make a difference at this point in time. That's the difference between the voting members and the paid members. There are benefits for both. Lila is on this committee. There's three of us. There's Robert Andrews, myself, and Lila. And are you on this too? No. No, okay. What it is that the list that we have, we've created, moved over to an access database, and it's quite simple for us to print and make a printout and figure out where everybody is in a database. You can do that real fast. So we've moved that over to the access database, and Lila now is calling, starting to call members whose memberships have expired, because at one time, we did have up something like over 200 members, and that was attributed to Cabin Fever 2011, where if you came in the door, you became a member. This year, our committee, our board of directors said, if you are a member, just because you come in the door at Cabin Fever, you don't necessarily are a member when you pay at the door. So the 74 paid members is a real number now, and that's what we're going with. The recommendations that we have as a committee is that the small fee band of $50 be dropped from the fee schedule, mainly 1 to 4 members, and that's one of our recommendations so that we each have only have the member itself. Music NWT we recommend that Music NWT hosts monthly all ages venues with the intent of attracting musicians in the community to network, socialize, and build community. One idea had put out was maybe one of the venues could be another different night on Jav Roma or some other night anywhere else that we're hosting stuff. The idea is that some of the ideas that Talia threw out there were we would pay an artist to play for 10 or 15 minutes. And we have to talk, and bring in some people to talk about the arts world itself. Those are some of the ideas. That's it.
Any comments, questions, concerns?
Thank you. I'll pass it on to Leela. It was her idea.
Yes, Travis? Sorry, Travis, I can barely hear you. Can you repeat, please?
Is there any businesses that take on the office of bylaws?
I don't have any specs on that, but I can do some research and let you know. I would imagine, though, that it would be a very small component, if any at all. We'll have to do some research and get back to you on that, Travis. Jonathan? As a support, absolutely. And that definitely is our role. We are a volunteer board, including our ED and assistant ED. So we do our very best with the time that we have. And I'd like to point out, Jonathan, that your comment about Javaroma could very well be one of those businesses that is succeeding because of music. They host their weekly jams, such as The Twist. I know that the Top Night is a popular jam spot, as well as the Mackenzie Lounge when they do the Folk on Fridays. Is that what it's still called?
That's what it's called.
That is what it's called. Thank you, Jessica, as the host. Sorry, Mary, I missed that last bit. So it's really hard. Oh, thank you, Ted. And it's not on.
Oh, hello. Oh, hi. No, well, I just wanted to say that I feel like it isn't a role that Music NWT can fill, because there's a conflict of interest there. And so I don't know if you were like totally getting what Travis was saying, where there's that gap of someone who could represent artists in a professional capacity, you know, where I don't think Music NWT can. Anyway, I just wanted to highlight that, because someone was like, oh, well, that's what the board's trying to do. But I don't think the board could do that.
No, I think you're right, and that's a great point for clarification. It's kind of really hard to hear with the fan behind us, but I didn't catch that, so thank you for bringing that up. Of course. Hold on, Greg.
Sorry, I don't know if you're going to be able. Yeah, you will hear. We do have a person who is in Yellowknife who is trying to start up a company representing artists and is doing so right now. What's the name of the company, Darren? Yeah. Dude with a guitar. Darren is representing different artists and booking them into spots. And I understand you're looking to expand that business and become a full-time professional at it. So, I mean, there are people out here who are trying, but we're probably not. And Travis, I know you have a business as well that is supported by music and supports musicians. It may not be known well throughout the North, but that's where we can post on our website and maybe help support the people who are trying to work with musicians and give an audience to them.
Does that help? Does that make sense to you guys?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Okay. As well, it should be noted that if anybody wants to upload their music onto the Music NWT website, you're welcome to do that. As long as we have your permission to do that, we'll get it up as best we can. Did you have a question, Howard? No? Just wiping the eyes. All right. Any other comments? No? Okay. Thank you. On to the Cabin Fever report. Back to you, Ted.
That's over to Greg.
Oh, it's over to Greg?
Oh, here we go. That's probably close enough, Ted. Oh, a personal microphone holder, what I need. Cabin Fever, this is the second year that I've been involved with it, and as most of you know, I started off the year as president of Music NWT, and due to health problems, I took a back seat. And I thought that I was truly out of the whole thing and just was going to advise this board as to what had to happen. And then all of a sudden, somehow or other, I got nominated to run Cabin Fever, which is probably one of the busiest events we do. We had 84 performers at Cabin Fever this year. Each one of them started off with a minimum of $100 payout. If you played a second time, it went to $50. Third time, it was $25. And the fourth time, I think there was only two people that got this, three actually, got $12.50. So it was a very successful event. The addition of the side door youth component, it was amazing. We had the side door calling us up saying, a bunch of drunk musicians just showed up at our door, what are we going to do with them? Put them on stage. And they did, and they called back and said it was amazing. These guys interacted with the kids, they got them involved, they had fun with them, and the kids had fun. There was no profanity, no problems or anything else like that. And we had some sober musicians show up and play there too. But we all know that's fairly rare. Again, we're set to do this in two venues next year. We're looking at Hay River. It will be a two-day event there. We're hoping to make it a three-day event here with the help of Black Knight, Top Knight. We're going to try to do it Friday night, Saturday night, and all day Sunday, which will give even more spots and hopefully keep things busy and keep them hopping. Again, the Black Knight, Top Knight, have been instrumental in helping us with Cabin Fever right through the whole time it's been around. The city of Yellowknife also was a good donator, gave us a good bit of money. ITI helped us out a lot. Canadian Heritage and many of the local businesses pitched in money to support bands. So it really is truly a community event. And the idea that we actually got to pay our performers fairly well for what we did made me very happy to be part of this organization. It is our one showcase event that we do every year. We're not in the business of setting up performances, but we feel that this event, Cabin Fever, will give a highlight to our northern performers and bring young performers out that probably haven't been seen too many times, get them in front of an audience and maybe get them started on their path. The rest of everything that has been said about Cabin Fever was said by Brenda, and Ted is about to break down all the dollars, which he does so well. My feeling is that I know that Cabin Fever is a cost to Music NWT. We pay some money out of our pocket. I'm happy to do it. Thanks very much.
Any comments, questions, or concerns for Greg? Yes, Carmen? Ted's going to speak to the financials.
Okay, I'm going, I'll email you them if you wish, because I didn't bring them. I ran out the door and left the wrong, grabbed the wrong binder. I have a binder now for everything. Seeing I'm now the secretary and the treasurer, I got a binder for everything. But we did not lose money, which is the most important thing. So we, because we didn't lose money, we created a budget at the beginning and we followed the budget to the end, which allowed us to plan to pay the artists who played. We had a lot of donations as grant in kinds. I had a huge spreadsheet I had to report back to the to Canadian Heritage on. And I'm willing to share this spreadsheet. It's about, it's 11 by 17, and it's all in small print. But I can share with you, Carmen. Yes, it is. Just give me a second. I want to make sure. Can I get back to you, Carmen? Because I, all the information I provide to all our support, funding supporters, like all our grants, like City of Yellowknife and Karen Canadian Heritage and ITI, I want to make sure I gave it to our bookkeeper, so it's what's in there. I all the money went out and in our account is in there. No, the 84 performers is if you played twice, that counts as two, not one. Does that help you a little bit before we get into detail? So if Greg played four times, because he did, so we got $150 and $175 for three performances, and he donated just $12.50. Okay. Okay. Thank you, Darren.
Thank you, Darren.
Because we have a different year end already in place. Thank you, Darren.
Travis?
I have some comments about the Cabin Fever Festival. I played as part of Sinister Oculus, and I don't mean to criticize, I guess, but there's just a couple observations I found. I don't think we should be running something at a loss for something that should ultimately make money. And I think in music, if we don't make money, then there must be a reason why we're not getting that engagement and that attendance. And I think one thing I found about the Cabin Fever Festival was that it was very musician orientated. And I felt that was really great, but that by being so good to the musicians, in some way there wasn't a lot of expectation for what the audience would be kind of contributing to this thing. And I know from playing a lot of smaller festivals around the north, if attendance is low, then it's like nobody gains anything. Like, because then you have the people that are there, they just don't feel like they're anybody else is excited because nobody feels like they're part of something. And then the musicians just inherent and then don't in turn play. I think maybe one of the things is having it in a bar, and especially a dark bar. I feel like it's very dreary, and there isn't that kind of visibility that there are all these musicians that are here, and that we need to make something that's more like Folk in the Rocks is able to do something. So I think Music NWT needs to find that marquee kind of thing and really use it as a way to remind people that these musicians are there, but at the same time to also be support the audience, because I think that's where I as a musician lately I've been finding that the harder I play, the more engaged I try to be in my performances. I find that people end up being more, people come back to our shows. And it's like, where do we get to that point where people feel like they're a part of something? And it's kind of like scene building in like a city. You see the scene develop because people start glomming together because that energy is put there. And it's like, we need to find that kind of thing. And I don't know, I think there'd be interesting to find ways in which Cabin Fever can maybe try a couple of different angles. Like, rather than have all this stuff one continuous day, do like a week of you know, three or four bands a night at different venues, but don't have things compete against each other, but spread it out. Because I feel like when it was really long, some people were here for 4 or 5 hours. They were drained after, like, you know, two or three sets, because it was such a long stretch. So you didn't get a sense of when is it going to peak, or when should I go? So people were like coming and going, and it just felt like I mean, it was great otherwise, but that was the one observation.
Those are excellent ideas and comments.
Some of that. So one of the things, Travis, that's why we plan to do it over three nights this time, is actually shorten up the days, Friday night, Saturday night. Sunday, we never have a problem drawing a crowd, because basically it's the only place you can drink on Sunday and come in and have a show. And as to making money, we've got to watch that, because we're a nonprofit society. So when we budget for an event such as this, we want to come as close as we possibly can to breaking even with the payouts and what we bring in. If we start to show a profit, then we are a promoter, and that's not what we want to do, or what not what we're allowed to do. So we kind of have to play it very close to the $0 mark. Mm-hmm. Say again.
One of the issues that happened this year, technically, is that we were trying for Saturday, Sunday, and then the Sunday we couldn't get it for the liquor license, so we couldn't get in here on Sunday. So we had it Friday, Saturday. And we had a long day on Saturday, just like you're saying, and that was unfortunate. So we're trying to shorten up the timelines, because we went from 1 o'clock until 2 o'clock. That's just a long day, because I was here all weekend.
I appreciate your observations that it is for a long event, and I would encourage you to become a member of the committee for the next event so that we can incorporate some of your ideas. Thank you, Travis. Yes, Mary.
I didn't realize there was a committee. I was just going to say maybe you should have a subcommittee, because I know advertising was a little like close to the event this past time, and that probably didn't help draw people in either. But if there is a committee already, maybe make it a little more known that you are like putting it out there. Like, I don't know if you do a call for volunteers or something, but maybe like a month before the show, people would be interested, I think, in helping to build it into something. If you, because I know you guys are stressed as a board, like you're all volunteering and stuff, so I think there'd be lots of people that would be interested in helping out for that one event who don't want to actually commit to sitting on the board.
Calls for volunteers have been happening throughout the year with little to no response. So when that call went out, we had one person volunteer for the weekend. Yes, Natasha? Sorry, we'll come back to you, Mary.
Maybe you guys did do it, but I don't ever remember getting any notification that there was a committee being formed for the Cabin Fever Festival, so I'm not sure if...
But how would you want to hear about it?
Well, I guess either one is fine. Yeah, word of mouth or whatever. Like, I know, for example, Vagina Monologues, they're very much volunteer-based, and it's because they have people that are really committed to the project who rally people around and build that energy, you know? So, I mean... Sometimes I get lots of posts on Facebook. I don't always read them all. Maybe it's just getting lost in the, you know, the filing of the information.
We'll have to incorporate those ideas. And some of our challenges I'll relate to in just a moment. And that is definitely one of them. Do we have any other comments or questions regarding Cabin Fever? Okay, then we'll move ahead to the report on Music NWT accomplishments and challenges. In 2011, the majority of our funding was declined, as many of you in the room that have ever applied for funding, you know that it's kind of a hit to your entire programming for the year, and that was the majority of our objectives that we could not obtain due to the lack of funding for 2011. We had to scrap or postpone the Ambassadors of Music NWT. We had to put on hold working in partnerships with the smaller communities. We had to put on hold our website and membership database projects that were in the works as well. But we have managed to work together with the communities to obtain government support. And we've also successfully partnered with NAC, Folk in the Rocks and Sidedoor in 2011. The majority of our challenges are going to be continuing only because now with a volunteer board and no operational funding, we have a huge pile of work that we need to do, incorporating all of the objectives we wanted to happen in 2011 are now being pushed forward to 2012, and we're finding ourselves in a backlog. So if there are any members out there that want to lend a hand and become a board member or sit on a subcommittee, we would definitely take your assistance in any way, shape, or form. And that's pretty much it for our accomplishments and the challenges in 2011, besides a successful Cabin Fever two-day event.
I just have one quick question. Because I was just thinking, if you're not getting all of this money, but you're not allowed to make a profit on Cabin Fever, couldn't you make a profit on Cabin Fever and put that back into society?
I'll talk to the finances. That's fraud.
It's government reporting. You have to spend every dime that you receive, as with any funding that anyone here has received from NWT Arts Council or Heritage Canada. You can't make a profit.
But not a profit. Back
into the funding. Yeah, as like a fundraiser.
That's a separate issue. Not allowed.
So like, not taking money that you would get from funding. That has to, of course, go to the show. But the idea, like, whatever you make above and beyond that in terms of holding the show from attendance, that can go back into the coffers, right?
You can do a bit of sleight of hand. And I've done it. I know how to do it. But you just got to be careful. And I'm on, by the way, Reverend Kenner can watch this.
That's good.
The watch list.
Yeah, I don't quite understand.
Yeah, because I know.
Actually, the only funds that we actually raise during Cabin Fever are the ticket sales, and those go back into paying for bands, venue, advertising, our thank you ads. It's all gets eaten up. The fund that we received for Cabin Fever this year was only a portion of what we requested.
Oh yes, just like if there was were we able to pull in a lot of money, I mean, that would still go back in the organization to fund other projects, right? Like, as a fundraiser, I mean, that's...
I'll just add one comment, Travis, is that the idea is that if you have a more than one stage of a Cabin Fever, I think you can do that. Exactly what both you and Mary are saying. You can carry it into another entity. If you apply for funding on a one event, You're doing a final reporting on that event.
I'm just wondering if the whole approach is a little bit like illogical, because I think Travis talked earlier about how important it is to have a big crowd and how good it is for the musicians and the whole community and everything. And so maybe instead of being so worried about we're only getting $2,000 and we have to spend it back, you know what I mean? Like, you could make a lot of money on Cabin Fever if it drew in a big crowd. And I think to say we don't want to draw in a big crowd because the profits will be too high, why not just have high profits and reapproach the whole thing? I think it'd be really cool if it was like a really well-attended, popular event.
But we still have to spend it.
Yeah, and there's tons of stuff to spend it on.
That's why you're trying to. What you would end up doing is basically changing Cabin Fever, which is okay. But the way to do it is get on the board and do it. I mean, they're all good ideas. And that's where we need people like yourselves with ideas who will come and work with the committee. I'm tired. I'm at the end of my run with this. I'm past president. Once I drop out of that position, I will help Music NWT any way I can, but I'm not going to take a seat on the board of directors. We need fresh blood and fresh ideas. You guys are it. Come forward. We'd be welcoming you, believe me. Thanks. That's it for me.
Any other comments or questions? Okay, we're going to move on to the Constitution and Bylaw Amendments. Now, these changes, required changes, came about through our Board Governance Workshop. Correct.
It wasn't done last year.
Right. Yeah. These changes will be submitted with approval for this year's annual report. And we'll just go through each one by one. Presently, Music NWT name of society is Music NWT, formerly known as Recording Arts Association Northwest Territories. We would like that changed to straight Music NWT. Now, do you guys want to vote on these each as we go, one by one? Okay. All right, we'll do it one by one then. So if I could have a motion to accept the name of the society to be changed to Music NWT. Motion from Darren, thank you. A seconder? Well, I've got both of you, so we'll say you this time. Seconded by, I'm sorry, it flew right out of my head. Howard Mackay. Thank you, Howard. All those in favor? Any opposed? Motion carried. Thank you. Yes, Jonathan? You are correct. It is a point that I have consistently been making wrong all night, so thank you for bringing that to my attention. All right. Do we have any discussion concerning the change of the name of Music NWT? No? Motion carried. We'll finish that bit off right. All right. The second point for change is the objectives of the society. Did everyone receive a copy of the... okay. Kim, were the projected changes printed? No? Okay, I guess I'll just read them out. Currently, the objects of the society are read as to foster the continued growth of music NWT in the NWT, music industry in the NWT, pardon me, support the distribution and marketing of NWT recording artists, and provide opportunities for training and education for the music industry in the NWT. We propose to change this to adding the Music NWT mission statement that reads to develop, foster, and promote the continued growth of the Northwest Territories music industry to its fullest potential. Further, to add Music NWT mandate for the benefit of the membership to support the marketing and distribution of Northwest Territories recording artists, to provide opportunities for education and training of Northwest Territories musicians and recording artists and the Northwest Territories music industry. To increase recognition of the music industry as a vital element of the economy and cultural identity of the Northwest Territories, and provide a voice to government, businesses, and the communities at large throughout the Northwest Territories regarding the issues facing the music industry. Can I have a motion to accept these new changes? What did I miss? Sorry? Oh, Natasha? Thank you, Natasha. Do I have a seconder? Thank you, Darren. Any points to discuss? Yes, Jonathan? Provide a voice to government, business, and the communities at large throughout the Northwest Territories regarding the issues facing the music industry. Travis?
Without the professional, I think the industry exists, as we mentioned before, with just a couple of businesses. What are we going to do to try to sort of get there to be some kind of, I don't know, economic development or some way in which people do these things? Because the music industry is kind of missing the industry aspect of it. You know, we don't really have that.